For a moment, imagine COVID-19 robbing your chance to say a final goodbye to your friend and loved one. How would you feel about this predicament? Well, several individuals are heartbroken by the current COVID-19 regulations implemented by death care services. St. Lucian Dennis Christoph was in great agony when he spoke with the press about the matter.
On the day of the burial, I can't even see my girlfriend for the last time. I don't care with people. If I have to go and see my girlfriend, I go and see my girlfriend. I can't see my girlfriend for the last time. I can't even give my girlfriend a kiss. My girlfriend was there for me. They said the day of the burial, we can't see the lady. They can't open the coffin, the lady in the body bag.
On the Beyond the Headlines program, Mrs. Sunasi Maharaj Best, Managing Director of the Lloyd Best Institute, elaborated on the sealed casket issue. She specifically highlighted that it is a heart-wrenching situation for many.
The other horrible thing about this infectious disease is that when your loved one contracts it and goes into the hospital, it is the last time, if they die, that you're going to see them. You get a sealed casket that you can go to in a very small number to the funeral home. The state pays for the cremation and gives you the ashes. None of us want to have that experience. And that is what should tell you, do you want to be part of do you want anybody that yourself or your family or loved ones can actually contract this thing and die, and you never get the chance to hold their hand and see them, even in the hospital, to say a prayer with them.
Similarly, Mr. Julian Rogers, Managing Director of the Observer newspaper, shared sentiments with Mrs. Best. He conveyed that this saddening reality ought to be a wake-up call.
And I think the point I would make in reinforcing what you said, Sunidhi, is that the vaccine is intended to stop you from getting seriously ill and being hospitalized. I think when we look at the situation in India and the fact that their health services are overwhelmed, oxygen not available for a sufficient number of people, and people are dying in the street, inside the compound of the hospitals, etc. And literally, their families don't know that they're dying. They're just gone. You know, all these public fires, etc. That should be more than a wake-up call for many of us in our Caribbean.
More issues like this will be dissected in the next edition of the Beyond the Headlines. Krista Campbell, GBN News.